Hey there, I am Parth Doshi, exploring the field of RPA and sharing my learnings with you by making videos. So, this video is about publishing our component on UiPath Connect. We many times while practicing get new ideas on which we build different workflows, or you can say we build different bots. Now, how can you showcase your that particular idea or that particular workflow using UiPath Connect? So in this video, we'll be seeing how you can create a component, what are the different components you can publish, and how you can make and share your idea with the community people of UiPath. So without any delay, let's get started. Now to publish your component on UiPath Connect, you need to go to UiPath Connect. Just type in this UiPath Connect and click on the first option, connect.uipath.com. Now this is the screen you will see when you search connect.uipath.com. Now let's see what are the different components we can upload. So to upload a component, you need to, first of all, you need to create your profile using your Gmail ID or email ID or password, whatever you want. After that, you need to click on upload components. Now when you click on upload components, this particular screen will appear. Now let's first see what are the different components we can publish. So the first one is custom activity. So if you have built any custom activity using the Visual Studio Code or the library that is reusable components, you can publish that particular activity. One of the example would be, we can say, unit conversion. So I'm learning that activity, I have to build that activity. So that is one of the thing which can be an example of custom activity. The other is snippet. So one of the snippet which I have published is OTP verification. So what it does is it basically sends an OTP to the entered email ID in UiPath form. And then once you enter the correct ID, you will see the registration successful. You can check that in my profile. I will attach the links below in the description. Workflow template is, if you have designed some workflow and you want to publish that, then there is connector. So basically connecting UiPath with some other CRM applications, you can say, or any other applications. Then there is dashboard, machine learning model, solution. So if you think you have built some complete use case, which is like complete implementation of a particular idea, so you can publish that as a solution. Then there is demo. So if you want to show demo of some particular idea you have, and then there is developer tools. So these are the different component types you can publish on UiPath Connect. Now to publish it, as I said, you need to click over here on upload connect. After that, you need to give a appropriate name to your component which you would like. So for example, if you are creating, I have created the registration decks with camera integration. So the name of that component was registration decks with camera integration. So this is the first step you need to perform, that is giving a component. Now the second is summary. Give a 2-3 line of short summary of why you have built that particular workflow or activity or a machine learning model or a dashboard. Give a short summary about that. After that, you need to explain in detail what is your this particular component, how it can be used, what is the idea you had and why you built this component. So that is the thing you need to write over here, overview. Do it completely. If there are any particular steps you have followed, and then you can use the bullet points, you can use this bold, italic, underlined, and all the formatting features you have. So here you need to give a complete overview. After you have done that, you need to select the suitable component type. Let me select workflow template over here just for the demo purpose. Then you need to select the industry, whichever you think best suits your application or your idea. Let me do information. Of the technology, whatever. So if you are using connector or something, these are the technology you can use, or you can just put whatever is appropriate according to your application. Then process is information technology. There are human resources. You can add multiple processes, sales, whatever you feel is for. Relevant text. So if you are using, suppose you are creating a unit conversion activity, then what you can do is you can define centimeter, meter, conversions, unit conversions, data expressions, or anything. You can give the relevant text. Now here there are three options: component target. It is a lead generation link, then your email ID, external link, then the link of that particular component, and if it is a downloadable component. Always try to give a downloadable component in the cases of workflow template, or you can say a solution or a demo. So here what you need to do, now component package, here you need to zip your complete workflow or your complete activity, whatever you have built, you have to completely zip it and upload over here. You can upload both the same files in the component package and in the source code. Now the license tag, you can select it as open source and select any one of them, Apache 2.0. Now here I are by okay. After that version, if you are publishing it for the first time, 1.0.0. Now the release notes, whatever you fill. So if it is a first time, you can write initial release. Now here you need to specify the benefits. So benefits can be like why you are building that activity or why you are building that workflow, how it can be useful to the community people, how it can be useful in business processes, anything. Whatever the benefits you feel, you need to mention it over here. Now the compatibility. Now you need to specify the compatibility, whether it is compatible with the current version of UiPath Pro Community or the previous version, whatever it is. And dependencies. So suppose you are using some other packages. So for example, in document understanding, we use document understanding ML activities, intelligent OCR activities. So any dependencies or any packages which you install, other than the by default packages and activities which are installed, you need to specify all of them over here. If you specify all of them over here, it might get approved in the first go and no problems with that. Now here, so it is always better to create a demo video. So, or and include the images. So whenever you are publishing it, so the user should understand what is your component and all. So visual representations are always useful. So create a short video and put it on YouTube about describing your complete workflow, activity, dashboard, or anything it is. Add images and videos, take some screenshot, whatever you feel. Here also you can include README files, manual PDF, if there are some particular instructions to be followed. So if you are using some integrations or something, you might put a README file like generate an API key, etc., etc., whatever it is. Now, if that feature is available in community and enterprise growth, you can select community. Otherwise, if it is specific to enterprise support, so for example, it can be AI Fabric feature, which is the new feature of UiPath. It is only available in the enterprise version. So you need to select your enterprise support or else community support. Here, you need to agree all the guidelines. So now there are some UiPath basically make sure that the component you upload is very well explained with all the details, with all the README files, or with all the instructions required for the user. So there are some guidelines you need to follow while you publish a component on UiPath Connect. I will be adding a description, a link in the description which you can check out. I've written an ebook on which there are guidelines and instructions on how to publish a workflow template, a snippet, and a solution. So please do check it out if you want to publish your component as a workflow template or solution or a demo or a snippet on UiPath Connect. Do check it out. I have included all the instructions with proper guidelines and how you can publish it. Also, it has my contact number and email ID. So you can reach me out if you need any help in publishing a component. I will be very happy to help you and make your idea available to the community people. Thank you for watching the complete video. Please do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that yet and press the bell icon to stay updated. Now the last thing, if you have filled all the details properly, you just need to click on create component and you will get reply within seven working days on whether your component is published or not. And one more best part is, if your component is not published, the UiPath community replies you with all the changes you need to make to your workflow with all the minute details. Even if there are spelling errors or typo errors, anything, whatever the changes are to be made, if you need to change the component type or anything, all the instructions will be mailed to you as a reply on your component. Thank you.